The beat. Who's on first?
You.
I thought I was on second.
No. Oh.
Button up your overcoat when the wind is free. Take good care of yourself. You belong to me. Eat an apple every day. Get to bed by 3. I want you to take good care of yourself. You belong to me. Be careful across the street. Don't eat meat. Lay off wheat. You get a pain and ruin your tum-tum. Keep away from blended stuff when you're on a street. Take good care of yourself. You belong to me.
We talked about London tailors and their custom of not sending bills to clients.
Oh, yes, I recall vividly that merry discussion.
Well, Bing, I got a big shock for you and all the other fellows who've been preying on these poor British tailors.
What's the shock?
Well, that custom of not sending bills is coming to an end.
Well, then the world's coming to an end.
Bing, you're turning pale.
Oh, no, I have authentic word that London's top tailor has sent bills out to customers asking them to pay debts totaling $1,732.18.
Merciful, save us, said Mrs. Davis. You say $1,732.18?
Wow, this is a very prominent tailoring firm.
I know who it is, too.
How so?
Well, it just happens that I owe my London tailor $732.18.
Did you get a bill?
No, but I keep track.
How considerate of you.
You just look out. Your bill will be along any day now.
I guess I'm trapped.
Apparently so. No doubt, if there's a big firm that sends out bills and demands payment, other firms in London are going to follow suit, don't you suppose?
I'm afraid so. Looks like the ice is broken.
Oh, it's the beginning of a movement. No doubt about that.
That's a trend. This is going to come as a tremendous shock to a lot of Englishmen. I'll tell you that.
The fellow who used to stand around his club and brag about how much he owed his tailor now will be lying on some psychiatrist's couch bemoaning his fate, won't he?
Oh, it's going to be a big jolt, all right. Be a lot of cricket bats and punts and shooting sticks turn up at the hawk shops. It foretells the sounding of the death knell for British tailoring.
Oh, I don't know. I don't see why. Their tailoring won't be affected any. It's just that the tailors want to get paid for their work.
Yes, imagine one firm with outstanding debts of $1,732.18. Disgraceful.
Well, I got news for you, Rosie. The $732.18 are going to be sent to them today. So from now on, you can just refer to their outstanding debts. $1 million even.
Well, Bing, may I say, you're a brick for starting the ball rolling.
You're so white to say that, really. I'll bet it hurts the tailor more to send the bill than it does the client to receive it.
Oh, you still feel that strongly about a British tailor's charitable attitude?
Yes, huh? I do. And although I'm shocked and shook up, I guess I've just got to carry on with the program here, don't I?
Chin up.
Of course, Ken and I can take over in case you want to run and see your psychiatrist.
Well, if I go anywhere, I'll go out and hawk a few things. No, I'm going to stick around. I'll be a little jumpy, a little preoccupied, but I'll be here, carrying on.
Valiant is the word for Crosby.
Oh, what a spot for a song.
From me?
I'll take it, Bing.
If you loved me half as much much as I love you, you wouldn't worry me half as much as you do. You're nice to me when there's no one else around. You only build me up to let me down. If you missed me half as much as I miss you, you wouldn't stay away half as much as you do. I know that I would never be this blue if you only loved me half as much as I love you. As you do, I know that I would never be this blue if you only love me half as much as I love you.
Bing, feeling better now?
Yes, I've been sniffing on a few ammonia ampules. But I still contend that a British tailor worthy of his stripe would rather swallow a mouthful of pins than annoy a customer with a bill. I really do.
You never thought you'd live to see a day when your tailor would needle you for money, huh?
Never. I never did. He just never sent bills out. He realized the cause was futile.
Well, believe me, he's making a stab at it now.
I can't understand why a tailor wouldn't accept cash.
Well, I suppose maybe it's because he frowns on your stuffing your pockets with things, including money.
But paying would be unstuffing pockets, wouldn't it?
But first you'd have to stuff them, you see. To unstuff them, you get the threads all out of shape.
Well, I can say it's a wonderful old custom that's come to an end.
An end we deplore. Think of it. Some tailors only sent bills out once a year. Think of that, once a year, and others never sent bills.
And you couldn't pay cash.
Oh, girl, if you sprung any green in a tailor's shop, you might be asked to take your business elsewhere immediately if you offer him cash.
And to think that this is all over now.
And to think that all these years I've been buying my clothes in this country.
And paying for them.
And sometimes even cash.
Well, good things must come to an end, mustn't they?
Yeah, even conversations.
Which happily leaves us with nothing to do but sing.
Look me over, lend me an ear. Fresh out of clover, mortgaged up to here. But don't pass the plate, folks, don't pass the cup. I figure whenever you're down and out, the only way is up.
And I'll be up like a rose, but high on the vine. Don't thumb your nose, bud, take a tip from mine.
I'm a little bit short of the elbow room, but let me get me some. And look out, world, here I come. Nobody in the world was ever without a prayer.
How can you win the world if nobody knows you're there?
Kid, when you need the crowd, the tickets are hard to sell. Still, you can lead the crowd if you can get up and yell. Thank you.
me over, lend me an ear. Fresh out of clover, mortgaged up to here.
But don't pass the plate, folks, don't pass the cup. I figure whenever you're down and out, the only way is up.
And I'll be up like a rosebud, high on the vine. Don't thumb your nose, bud, take a tip from mine.
I'm a little bit short of the elbow room, but let me get me some. Hear me shout, world, here I come. Hear me shout, world, here I come.
Say, neighbors, how are you feeling today? Hope you're fine. But you know, lots of folks this time of year suffer from colds. So if you're feeling down in the dumps from those miseries, and you want really fast relief, listen.
Movie stars can't let cold and sinus congestion spoil their performance. So what do? Listen to Rod Cameron's answer.
When my head gets stopped up from cold and sinus trouble, I take the new medicine for those miseries. New four-way cold tablets. Today's four-way contains a decongestant to drain sinus congestion while it relieves cold distress. Then you feel better fast.
Tests show four-way acts faster than any other leading cold or sinus tablet. In minutes, four-way speeds pain-relieving medicine all through your body. In the same time, no trace with other brands. Only four-way starts so fast to relieve muscular pains, reduce fever, relieve headache without upsetting stomach. And four-way drains sinus congestion to restore free breathing, too. Right, Rod Cameron?
It sure is. With four-way, I start to feel better right away.
To relieve cold miseries while you drain sinus congestion, get new four-way. Fastest acting of all the leading cold and sinus tablets. New improved formula, same familiar package. Only 39 cents.
I let a song go out of my heart. It was the sweetest melody. I know I lost heaven, 'cause you were the song. Since you and I have drifted apart, life doesn't mean a thing to me. Please come back, sweet music. I know I was wrong. Am I too late to make amends? You know that we were meant to be more than just friends. Just friends. I let a song go out of my heart. Believe me, darling, when I say I won't know sweet music until you return someday.
Got a riddle.
What looks like elegant traverse draperies acts like both draperies and Venetian blinds, yet actually is neither.
This I gotta see. I give up.
And me too.
Here it is. An Eastern Star vertical blind.
Now just wait. Just wait a doggone minute, will you? It looks like elegant draperies, but it's got slats. How can it act like draperies?
Ah, just watch. I pull this magic cord, and presto, they draw apart in the middle. You see, these are vertical slats.
Wait a minute. How about acts like Venetian blinds?
Okay. I pull this other cord, and the slats turn to face any direction to keep out light and air perfectly.
Well, what do you know? They come in 21 stunning colors and have DuPont's Ludox finish, which sheds dirt, ends washing forever.
Yeah, we know about Ludox. Tell us, Ken, where do we go for this window covering decorama?
Eastern Star verticals, as well as Eastern Star regular horizontal blinds, are custom made by local franchise dealers and sold in department and drapery stores throughout the country, where you'll also find famous roll-ahead custom Venetians, all by Eastern Products Corporation of Baltimore. For the name of your nearest dealer, folks, call this station.
You can catch us tomorrow at the same spot on your dial.
So long for now.
Thank you very much.
There's a fellow sharing the morning air with us on the CBS radio network every weekday. He may not sing as sweetly as Bing and Rosie, but he sure has a great way of entertaining the nation with his patter, his comic remarks, his musical forces, and his exciting guest stars. His name? Why, Arthur Godfrey, of course. Tune in, Arthur Godfrey Time, weekdays at this dial address,